100 meters underground on the France-Switzerland border, the European Organization for Nuclear Research, CERN, has built the largest particle accelerator on our planet. Over its years of operation, it has uncovered some of the most exciting and groundbreaking discoveries in all of physics. Is there something else happening there? Something probing beyond our current understanding of reality? Have they found anything? One of the goals of CERN is to understand how the universe is put together and how it functions on a fundamental level. Some of the leading theories that attempt to explain the whole of the universe, the theories of everything, include higher dimensions above the three dimensions that we experience every day. These higher dimensions are required for certain fundamental interactions to occur between the building blocks that these theories claim make up our reality. And these interactions should leave behind telltale signs in the lower down dimensions that we can interact with. These signs include detecting the traces of certain short-lived particles, as well as missing energy after certain particles like gravitons migrate to higher dimensions. Now, scientists with CERN are on the lookout for these specific occurrences. It is just a waiting game to see if evidence of these higher dimensions is found. What will the implications be for glimpsing these higher dimensions? What might be possible if scientists are able to access and utilize these higher dimensions? During the first moments of the Big Bang, both matter and antimatter were created in almost the exact same quantities. But luckily for us, there was slightly more matter than antimatter. So after these two opposites annihilate each other, the universe was left with the small leftover bit of matter that survived the battle. No one really knows why there was more matter than antimatter. It appears that there was simply an asymmetry in those early moments. But antimatter still holds many mysteries itself and may hold the keys to understanding much more about our universe, which has led many scientists to try to create and study this bizarre material. One of the first goals of antimatter researchers was to be able to create antimatter that they can then study for longer than a few moments. But as the name suggests, it is the opposite of matter. And as soon as they make contact, they will annihilate each other instantly in a violent explosion. Scientists are getting better though, and recently at CERN, a team was able to create antimatter and keep it stable for a total of 15 minutes, which is a fantastic leap forward in the effectiveness of these experiments. Black holes are the ultimate monsters of the cosmos, with their extreme mass and gravitational pull that will be the end to anything that ventures too close to its gravitational pull. There are scientists who have predicted that when the Large Hadron Collider smashes together subatomic particles, the energy and forces present will cause black holes to be created in the aftermath. And while this is technically true, CERN has said that the black holes that are created will exist on the quantum level of our universe, and will be much too small to have much of an influence or impact in the macroscopic world. This is reassuring, but there are still a lot of unknowns when it comes to the world of quantum gravity, and understanding its workings is still one of the top goals of modern physics. Could they be wrong about these minuscule black holes? Could they grow large enough to begin acting like a gravitational funnel as their larger counterparts do? CERN is also taking a look at one of the longest-lived mysteries in the field of physics that still has no widely accepted answer, the presence of dark matter. Scientists know that there is a huge chunk of mass in our universe that does not interact with light in ways that we can detect, leading some to believe that it may be made up of minuscule unknown particles that are prevalent throughout the universe. Some of these scientists are working at CERN and have been hoping for some time that when they smash particles together, they will catch a glimpse of a new particle that can give us the answers they need to finally understand what dark matter is. The leading theories all include some type of microscopic particles that exist in insane numbers throughout the cosmos, while remaining undetectable to our current instruments. There are a number of particles that may be the answer to what dark matter is. But one with the most momentum behind it right now is the mysterious axion particle. While the standard model currently consists of 17 fundamental particles that make up our universe, there are many more theoretical particles that have yet to be discovered. Axions are one of the theoretical particles that have a high probability of appearing in collisions in a particle accelerator, as the power and energy of these machines continue to climb. First proposed nearly 50 years ago, axions are now one of the candidates for dark matter, as the environment during the early universe, just after the Big Bang, was perfect for a huge number of these particles to be created. 2 years ago, in 2020, there were findings in Tokyo that turned out to be the first direct evidence of axions. Scientists at the LHC are now working on specifically engineered tests that have high enough energy for axions to form, allowing the researchers to directly detect them for the first time. Particle accelerators, like the ones created by CERN, send subatomic particles around and around until they reach speeds approaching the speed of light, before they are finally directed toward each other and forced to collide in a powerful crash. These collisions cause the particles being accelerated to smash open in a tremendous release of energy, sending fundamental particles flying as they decay into their constituents, and allowing scientists to peer into the subatomic world and study the interactions of the particles as they come out of these collisions. Recently, while accelerating and colliding protons, a particle was released that scientists weren't exactly expecting. Protons are typically comprised of two up quarks and one down quark. But when these protons collided, a heavier, strange quark was produced. Could this be the evidence of some new physics that hasn't been found before? But strange quarks are not the only thing being found in the aftermath of super energetic collisions. Quarks come in six different types of flavors: up, down, charm, strange, top, and bottom. While particles consisting of three quarks, like protons and neutrons, seem to be the most common type of particles, scientists learned that they are not the only ways that quarks can combine together. The LHC has continued to show scientists new types of never-before-seen particles, with the discovery of a new kind of pentaquark and the first tetraquark pair, in addition to a new type of tetraquark. In the last 2 years, many types of exotic new hadrons have been discovered, but scientists are still trying to understand what they are and how they decay into their constituents. If all of these new particles fit into the standard model, what will that mean for the future of physics? Can these particles have applications that can benefit humanity in some way? Over a decade ago in the year 2012, scientists at the Large Hadron Collider made an incredible discovery. The Higgs boson was found nearly 50 years after it was first theorized, and helped provide additional evidence to the standard model of particle physics. But CERN has yet to confirm another certain feature of the standard model that has been plaguing scientists for years: supersymmetry. One of the accepted but not proven properties of the standard model is that there is symmetry between fermions and bosons. Referred to as supersymmetry, it predicts partner particles for all of those already known that helps fill in some of the major gaps in the theory. Scientists at CERN have been trying to prove its existence for the past few decades. And if they can find concrete evidence that supersymmetry exists, it will be one of the largest scientific discoveries of all time. When will they find evidence pointing them toward an answer? Thanks for watching. Let us know what you think about CERN and its fantastic discoveries down in the comments below. See you next time on Matter.